Yeah, we always have a good time. Weather is hell, rain or it's sunshine. Yeah, we're all living the good life. Weather is hell, rain or it's sunshine. Yes.
Afternoon.
Hello.
Thomas was a tank engine who lived at a big station. He had six small wheels, a short stumpy funnel, a short stumpy boiler and a short stumpy dome. He was a fussy little engine, always pulling coaches about. He pulled them to the station ready for the big engines to take out on long journeys. And when trains came in, he'd pull the empty coaches away so that the big engines could go and rest. He was a cheeky little engine too. He thought no engine worked as hard as he did, so he used to play tricks on them. He liked, best of all, to come quietly alongside a big engine, dozing on a siding, and make them jump.
Wake up, lazy bones! Why don't you work hard like me?
He'd then laugh rudely and run away and find some more coaches. One day, Gordon was resting on a siding. He was very tired. The big express he always pulled had been late, and he had run faster than he'd ever run before so that he could make up for lost time. He was just going to sleep when Thomas came up in his cheeky way.
Wake up, you silly great mess! Sleeping all day? This isn't on. Do some hard work for a change, you can't catch me!
Silly little tank engine, I'll get him back for this.
And Gordon thought about just that. One morning, Thomas wouldn't wake up. His driver and fireman couldn't make him start. The fire went out and there was not enough steam. It was nearly time for the express. The people were waiting and the coaches weren't ready.
Come on, Thomas. Oh, it's no use. We'd better just get anyone to shunt the coaches.
I think not.
Why?
Firebox is a bit cold.
You're just lucky it's not your early start today.
At last, Thomas started.
Oh dear, oh dear. I'm so tired.
He fussed into the yard where the coaches were sitting.
Hurry up!
Take that!
Oh, oh, oh!
Now be quiet!
And he started for the station.
Where have you been? Yes, where have you been?
Thomas didn't answer.
Hurry up, you!
Hurry yourself!
And almost before the coaches had stopped moving, Gordon reversed quickly and was coupled to the train.
Get in quickly, please.
The signal went down, the clock struck the hour, the guard waved his green flag and Gordon was ready to start. Thomas usually pushed behind the big trains to help them start, but he was always uncoupled first, so that when the train was running nicely, he could stop and go back. This time, however, he was late, and Gordon started so quickly that they forgot to uncouple Thomas.
Come on, come on.
Pull harder, pull harder.
The train went faster and faster, too fast for Thomas. He wanted to stop, but he couldn't.
Stop, stop.
You can't get away, you can't get away.
Poor Thomas was going faster than he'd ever gone before. He was out of breath and his wheels hurt him, but he had to go on.
I shall never be the same again. My wheels will be quite worn out.
Everyone laughed to see Thomas puffing and panting behind.
Hurry, hurry, hurry.
At last, they stopped at the station. They uncoupled him, and then he ran on a siding out of the way. He had no breath. He just puffed slowly away to rest and had a long, long drink. He went home very slowly, and was careful afterwards never to be cheeky to Gordon again.
Oh, Thomas, had a bit of a ride, have you?
Leave me be.
Well, you'd better get my coaches and don't forget to be uncoupled.
I should be allowed to pull passenger trains. It's just not fair. I spent all my time pushing coaches around ready for you to pull on long journeys. When will I get my reward?
You seem like you had a great time pushing that one.
Funny.
Besides, you're too impatient. You're sure to leave something behind.
Rubbish. You just wait. I'll show you.
One night, he and Henry were alone. Henry was ill. The men worked hard, but he didn't get better. Now, Henry usually pulled the first train in the morning, and Thomas had to get his coaches ready.
If Henry is ill, perhaps I shall pull his train.
As soon as Thomas was ready, he ran to find the coaches.
Golly, you're early, dear.
Come along, come along.
There's plenty of time.
He took them to the platform and wanted to run round in front at once, but his driver wouldn't let him.
Don't be impatient, Thomas.
So Thomas waited and waited. The people got in, the guard and station master walked up and down, the porters banged the doors, and still Henry didn't come. Thomas got more and more excited every second. The fat controller came out of his office to sort out the matter.
What's going on here then?
Henry's ill, probably won't be able to pull the train.
Oh? They'll find another engine.
There's only Thomas.
You'll have to do it then, Thomas. Wait quick now.
So Thomas ran round to the front and back down on the coaches, ready to start.
Don't be impatient, Thomas.
But Thomas was too excited to listen to a word he said. What happened next? No one knows. Perhaps they forgot to couple Thomas to the train. Perhaps Thomas was too impatient to wait until they were ready. Or perhaps the driver pulled the lever by mistake. Anyhow, Thomas started.
Hang on a minute, Thomas.
Stop now, you!
Hey, Thomas!
Wait up, come on, Thomas! Whoa, whoa, whoa! Stop, stop, stop!
Thomas, however, misinterpreted the shouting.
They're waving because I'm such an important engine.
As Thomas approached the first signal box, he saw men waving and shouting.
They're pleased to see me. Most likely never seen me pulling a train before. Nice of them to wave. Henry says it's hard to pull passenger trains, but I think it's easy. Hurry, hurry, hurry!
Then Thomas approached a signal.
Here we are, Thomas. It's a danger. We better stop. You don't think there's a problem, do you? No, probably a cow on the line or something. So how's he doing?
Just fine.
What's that?
Did you check to see if we got the train?
You what?
Oh my god.
Bother! I must stop and I was going so nicely too. What a nuisance signals are.
The signalman ran out at once.
Hello, Thomas. What are you doing here?
Why, I'm pulling a train. Can't you see?
Where are your coaches then?
Thomas looked back.
Why, bless me. If we haven't left them behind.
Yes, you better go back quickly and fetch them. Sorry, mate, I just noticed.
Yes, look out for a scolding from the fat controller.
Heaven help us all.
Thomas was so sad he nearly cried.
Cheer up, Thomas. Let's go back and try again.
The bigger engines will never let me forget this.
Back Back at the station, all the passengers were talking at once. They were telling the Fat Controller, the Station Master and the guard what a bad railway it was.
This is ludicrous! To think I paid a lot of money for this!
Just settle down, everyone. The situation is fully under control.
Oh, look! Here comes Thomas now!
They were just about to complain at him too. But once they saw how sad he was, they couldn't be cross. So they coupled him to the train, and this time he really pulled it. But for a long time afterwards, the other engines laughed at Thomas.
Hey look, there's Thomas, who wanted to pull a train but forgot about the coaches.
Anyone would think he was impatient.
Thomas felt very silly. Eventually, the bigger engine stopped teasing the little blue tank engine, and Thomas saw the chance to moan.
I'm tired of pushing coaches around. I want to see the world.
The others didn't take much notice, for Thomas was a little engine with a long tongue.
One day, I'll show you all what I can do.
Dare I recall the last time you said that?
Slight blip. Could happen to anyone.
Right. Good night.
Days passed and Thomas wouldn't stop, but one night, Edward came to the shed. He was a kind little engine and felt sorry for Thomas.
I've got some trucks to take home tomorrow. If you take them instead, I'll push coaches in the yard.
Thank you. That would be lovely.
We'll ask our drivers in the morning. Sleep well.
Next morning, as soon as the driver arrived, Thomas wouldn't stop pestering.
Please, driver, can we? Please, please, please.
We'd have to sort it out with the Fat Controller, but I would consider it quite a treat.
So once everything was sorted, Thomas rushed off happily to find the trucks. Now, trucks are silly and noisy. They talk a lot and don't tend to what they are doing. They don't listen to the engine, and when he stops, they bump into each other, shouting,
"Ow! Ow! Whatever is happening!"
And I am sorry to say, they play tricks on an engine who is not used to them. Edward knew all about trucks. He warned Thomas to be careful, but Thomas was too excited to listen. The shunter fastened the coupling, and when the signal dropped, Thomas was ready.
Away you go, driver.
The line is yours, Thomas.
And the trucks grumbled slowly out of the siding onto the main line. Thomas was very happy.
Come on, come on, let's go.
All right, don't fuss.
They clattered through stations and rumbled over bridges.
The free open air, no stops. This is amazing.
Great to stretch your wheels, eh, Thomas?
Weesh!
And Thomas rushed through a tunnel. Eventually, they reached Gordon's Hill.
Give it your all.
Thomas puffed as hard as he could up the hill. Soon enough, he reached the top.
Yeah, steady now, steady.
His driver then shut off steam and applied the brakes.
We're stopping, we're stopping.
Oh no, we're not. Go on, go on.
Before Thomas's driver was given the chance to stop them, they began pushing Thomas down the other side of the hill.
Help me, Bob, help me!
Oh no.
Go on, go on!
Poor Thomas tried hard to stop them from making him go so fast. He was glad when they got to the bottom.
Oh no, oh no, oh no, we need to stop there!
Slow down!
They rattled through the station, and luckily the line was clear as they swerved into the goods yard.
God.
He skidded along the rails and was not far from the buffers now.
I must stop. I must.
He'd stopped just in front of the buffers, and there watching him was the Fat Controller.
Thomas, why were you going so fast when you arrived?
I'm really sorry, sir. I didn't mean to. I was pushed.
Haven't you pulled trucks before?
No, sir. I haven't.
Then you've got a lot to learn about trucks. They're silly things and must be kept in their place. After pushing them around here for a few weeks, you'll know nearly as much about them as Edward. And then, you'll be a really useful engine.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
So, Thomas worked at the station at the bottom of Gordon's Hill for a while. He liked a change and was glad he wasn't constantly disturbed by the bigger engines as much. Every day, the Fat Controller would come to the station to catch his train. Whenever he came, he'd always give Thomas a good morning greeting.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
Keeping the trucks in order? Just what I like to see.
Thank you, sir.
There were lots of trucks in the yard. Different ones came in every day, and Thomas had to push and pull them into their right places. He worked hard. He knew now that he wasn't as clever as he'd originally thought. Besides, the Fat Controller had been kind to him, and he wanted to learn all about the trucks so as to be a really useful engine. But on a siding, out of the way, were some queer-looking trucks that Thomas was told he must never touch.
Driver, what's that?
That's the breakdown train. A coach for the workmen, and a crane to lift whatever needs to be lifted at the accident scene.
Like?
Well, heavier things like coaches, engines, and trucks.
But it's not been used since we got here.
Probably because there hasn't been an accident nearby.
One day, Thomas was in the yard, when he heard an engine whistling in the distance. It then soon rushed through the yard, going much too fast.
Hello, what's this?
Help, help! They're pushing me, help me, please!
The engine's name was James. He was frightened. His brake blocks were on fire and smoke and sparks flew from his wheels.
Help, help! They're pushing me!
On! Go on!
A poor engine.
Probably one with those wooden brake blocks.
Oh yeah, that's true. He must be the new engine.
James's wheels turned furiously. His brakes were useless.
Reg, we're gonna die if we stay here.
We're so sorry, James, but we need to jump for it.
But James was too frightened to answer. The crew got the train as slow as they could, and the guard jumped for it too. Then it happened.
James is off the line! The breakdown train, quickly!
Thomas quickly buffered up and was coupled on. The workmen scrambled into their coach, and off they went.
Hurry.
And he was no longer pretending to be Gordon. He really meant it.
Bother those trucks. I hope poor James isn't hurt.
They found James and the trucks at a bend in the line. The brake van and the last few trucks were on the rails, but the front ones were piled in a heap. James was in the field with a cow looking at him.
Never mind, eh? It wasn't your fault. It was those wooden brake blocks they gave you. We all said they were no good.
Thomas pushed the breakdown train alongside. Then he pulled the unhurt trucks out of the way.
Serves you right.
Oh dear.
This'll teach you a lesson.
Yes it will.
Then, using the crane, they began to lift James back onto the rails.
Easy does it. Easy, come on. Keep him coming.
Great work.
James tried to move, but he couldn't, so Thomas helped him back to the shed. The Fat Controller was waiting anxiously for them.
Well, Thomas, I've heard all about it, and I can say one thing. You're a really useful engine. Well done. James shall be mended and will be fitted with some proper brakes. Thomas, you shall have a branch land all to yourself.
Oh, sir!
Now Thomas is happiest he could be. He has a branch line all to himself and puffs proudly back and forth with his coaches Annie and Clarabelle every day. He is never lonely because there's always an engine to talk to at the junction. Edward and Henry stop quite often to tell him the news. Gordon is always in a hurry and doesn't stop, but never forgets to whistle. And Thomas never forgets to whistle in return.